Being a parent isn't easy, but it just got a little easier with the Trackify wireless location system.
I watch a lot of cable TV news, so I know that everyone is out to abduct and kill my children. So I planted a microchip in their brains. Now, nobody will molest them but me.
Trackify shows your child's exact location at any time, and Trackify's innovative GPS locator chip is implanted at the base of their head, so there's nothing to lose. But Trackify isn't just for kids.
Getting microchipped is great for people like me who have Alzheimer's and wander into traffic. Broccoli! Highlighter!
Trackify. Love just got a little easier to keep track of.
Welcome, fans of Fallout 3, Fallout New Vegas, and the only graphic novel about the Fallout universe that's Fallout, the Descendants of Vols 42, 43, and 55, available on OutskirtsPress.com and Amazon.com as a download to your mobile device. Well, here we go. We've been walking the Capital Wasteland, and basically I'm doing my best to do a few little things until I can find the robot and buy the robot Mr. Gusty. I'm going to run into a lot of raiders, probably some mole rats, definitely the mutated grizzly bears, the Uyghur, and some infernal ghouls, hopefully no death claws. I'm not ready to deal with death claws at the moment. So kick back and enjoy the ride, and as usual in my universe, Fallout universe, music and comedy didn't die. I figured my Pip-Boy can play audio files that I find, and as a scavenger, I would have just as easily found audio files of stand-up comedy and music. So this is what my character would roll around listening to on the wasteland. And as everyone else, I am glad to hear there's a Fallout 4 and that it's scheduled for release this year. Let's hope that they actually add more selection of music and some comedy, because there's no reason why you have a couple of chemmed up ex-raiders holed up in a one-time video or record store spinning the tunes just like Three Dog. Anyway, enjoy.
Let's picking up married men in hotel bars. God, it's the story of my life.
Thank you. Hey!
Jason, I really miss you.
Me too. That's why I'm calling you on my new Wiz wireless camera phone. Hey, I just sent your phone a picture. Check it out.
Ugh, what's that?
My junk.
Connect. Live now. This is the moment. With Wiz Wireless, you can take pictures of yourself aroused and send it to friends. Play with your ringtones. Take a pic of your boss changing at the gym. Avoid people and save time by tapping out text messages that take 20 times longer than if you'd called. It's the incredibly lonely, passive-aggressive future of Wiz Wireless.
Can you see my junk now? Good!
Wiz Wireless. Do the social vibe.
Problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle to be free. There must be 50 ways to meet a lover. She said it's really not my habit to intrude. Furthermore, I hope my meaning won't be lost or misconstrued. But I'll repeat myself. At the risk of being cruel, there must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just come off the key and get yourself free. Back, Jeff. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. You just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key and get yourself free. She said it grieves me so to see you in such pain. I wish there was something I could do to make you smile again. I said, I appreciate that. And would you please explain about the 50 ways? She said, why don't we both just sleep on it tonight? And I believe in the morning you begin to see the light. And then she kissed me, and I realized she probably was right. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Or you hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key and get yourself free. Slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key and get yourself free.
This is getting out of hand. Can we get back on the topic, please?
Oh, you can have my wife. I don't care.
Thank you so much. I came here to talk about how our company, Betta Pharmaceuticals, has pioneered revolutions in pediatric care. It's a pill called Amphetarate that keeps kids quiet for hours. It's yellow. That means it makes you happy. Like in our animated commercials when frowns turn to smiles. It's also good if you ever feel self-conscious or awkward or awake.
Oh, great, because I wanted to sleep till I finally died.
Okay, but Mason, I thought you were all about homeopathic care. You know, natural solutions to people's problems.
You really talk like that? Hey, you know what, man? Don't stress me out. I am the homeo and the pathic. Together, you need to take a daily examination, a really thorough inspection of your bowel movements, get a fork, go through it, sift around, excavate. It's really fascinating. Nothing more fascinating. People come to me and they say, I don't feel so good. I tell them, well, save your eliminations for a week and bring them in a box. I can tell you what's wrong in a second. Now, this pharmaceutical lady is really nice with her little bubble tits and would make a fine receptacle for my DNA juice. And that's the only reason people listen to her. But listen, you don't need a pill for everything and barely for anything.
Okay, Mason brings up a good point.
Thank you.
This brings us to the topic of pre-existing conditions. Should you be denied insurance if you have one?
Absolutely! As an HMO, we want people to be healthy. Don't go to the doctor, don't get sick, pay your premiums on time, and everyone's happy. Why would we want to sign up sick people? If we were a sports team and we signed up sick players, people would be furious.
Our company has some fantastic athletic enhancement compounds in the works. One will double both your RBIs and your girth.
This blame the HMOs mentality isn't rational. If you're sick, why don't you harass someone who can do something about it, like God, instead of calling and harassing our call center workers? Health, Ryan. My wife and I have a 6-bedroom villa on the ocean in the Caribbean that we bring other couples to for healthy adventures. It's really all about health.
Some whales are into gay sex.
Exactly.
Look at how they swim.
Thank you. Life makes no sense when fish are gay. Back to pre-existing conditions, if your hip hurts, you should probably kill yourself. It's all over if you fall down and break a hip. Don't burden society or my bonus because you fell down. We mustn't become a nation of hypochondriacs. Just because you have insurance, why use it? Why should we pay just because we said we would?
Because you said you would.
What do you matter anyway? As a nation, we have to move forward, and we are obsessing about our healthcare system. I mean, come on! America fucking rules. We've got to conquer space and fight the war on terror, and you people are worrying about a stiff hip? Please, die.
Hey, did you know on the space station they have to drink their own piss?
Goodness gracious.
I can't understand.
Come on, what is wrong with that? That's an interesting thing to say. I'm talking about interesting. All you people want to talk about is money and co-payments and stuff. And I just talked about swilling piss.
Disgusting.
Steaming piss. Well, what is wrong with you people, man? No wonder you get sick. So pent up. You all need a good enema or you might explode. That's another thing we haven't talked about. Ryan, we ain't talked about it. Euthanasia. Why are they all prostitutes? Why is everyone staring at me?
I'm going to bring this back to topic. Speaking of foreign countries, we really need to step up the war on drugs in this country.
Now, that's a good point. What do you mean by that?
Well, I'm talking about these criminals. These geezer criminals who smuggle drugs over the border so people can get them at a cheap rate and not pay a fair market price that we control. Hard medication, my ass.
Well, Sheila, a lot of people can't afford your drugs through the conventional channels, and they're forced to buy them on the black market.
Boo-hoo!
Boo-hoo!
Save your money! Stop buying silly things like lottery tickets, pickup trucks, or food. We have pills that can save your life, and you're whining about the cost? It makes me want to throw up. People have to take responsibility. I mean, just the other day, this woman began to freak out in front of me and clutch her chest. So I did the responsible thing. I walked away. Yes, I work in the health industry. Yes, I had a purse full of life-saving heart drug samples, but I did not know if this woman had insurance. I did not know if she was going to sue me. So I did the responsible thing, and I left it to the professionals.
Wow, did you even call 911?
I left that to the professionals as well.
Well, what happened to this poor woman?
Well, she died. Bull lesson. First off, you wouldn't be having a heart attack in the street if you had gone to the doctor the day before and requested a prescription for a pill you saw on a TV commercial but don't know what it does. What it does is irrelevant. Ask your doctor for it.
My mother had a great home remedy. Home from the home for heart problems. A few ordinary household items. You'll find them under the sink, mixed together, drink problems solved. No bureaucracy. It's like my dad. I remember him telling me, son, diabetes is a lie. And he was in great shape because he hopped around on one leg a lot. Lemons to lemonade.
Okay, I understand what you're saying.
Like I said,
show hosted by two-time Southwestern tractor pulling finalist, amateur radio star, and animal husbandry innovator and expert, Dwayne Earle.
All right. We're back with another episode of Beyond Insemination. Welcome one, welcome all. You're listening to the show about BBQ, britches, mud bogging, and bitches. Your weekly journey into semen, sawdust, and savoring the good things in life. Life, death, and reproductive services down on the farm. Okay. Let's get some music playing here. Jesus, assault rock. I need some assault rock. Hell yes. You know, sometimes I just want a woman to hit me. Treat me like the man I am, a piece of angry garbage. And then when we're done fighting, I will hop on a motorcycle and I will pop a wheelie right there in the driveway. Just burn out. Skid all over the goddamn place. Hell yes. She'll stand there crying and then she'll forgive me. We'll have another baby. She'll make the breakfast. That's the stuff that makes us great. Grease, girls, and grits. All right, the phones are already lit up here. People just can't wait to get stuck in. Let's go to line four. Mr. Chuck, you're on the show. How can we go beyond insemination together?
Hey, Dwayne, I'm a big fan of the show, by the way, for the first time calling. I wanted to thank you for your fast fishing friends. No, you're right. Dynamite is much easier than all that sitting around with a pole going mad, spinning tiny ripples, wondering if everyone really hates you, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, I'm calling about the kids these days and the way they dress. Oh, man, my boy, he wears a skirt, got breast implants, wears a little lip gloss. What do you think, Dwayne? I don't think that's right.
Thanks, Chuck. I'm with you. I mean, platonically speaking, of course. I've about had it with gender fluidity. For reals. Seriously. For real, seriously. Men as men and girls as ladies. And there ain't no point in telling me different. I mean, it's getting to where boys have bigger titties than a woman. I know I do. It's gotta stop. I'll tell you what really sets me off. Let me tell you. Me and the boys will be having a great afternoon. Couple of cases of Lager Light, some steaks on the grill, jumping on four-wheelers and shooting assault rifles and playing on the trampolines and wrestling in a muddy hole with our tops off. You know, typical good time shit. And out of the corner of my periphery, I see these fruity fellas riding bicycles. City boys coming out to the country with their brightly colored jerseys and fruity hats and tight shorts. I don't want to see your Johnson. We ain't friends. And they ride bicycles with tap shoes on. Fucking tap shoes. Just in case they need to jump off and sing a show tune. What in the hell is that all about? Well, I ain't whistling Dixie, I can tell you that, because nobody likes a whistler. Creepy bastards. Whistlers. Next caller, inseminate me. No, that's wrong. Speaketh to me.
Hey there, Dwayne. My name's Big Sam.
I do not care about no names, boy. You state your business and I will do the pontificating, sir.
Anyway. My kid is real good at sports, like football and that. I think he's going to get a scholarship. He hits real good, real good, like one of them crackheads you read about them picking up north. But my wife won't let him play because his grades are low on account of him getting his girlfriend pregnant. Not my wife. My wife can't get pregnant no more. Uterus is ravaged like the projects. Anyway, I need that boy to make a lot of money by going pro so that I can get a new bass boat. What am I gonna do, Dwayne? I can't stop crying.
Brother, I share your pain. Let it go. Let those tears go. Let it all flow out your eyeballs, down to your cheeks. I love you, my brother. I love you. You're better than this. You are better than this, sir. Reach deep inside of yourself and just pinch it off. Don't you die on me. Don't you die on me. And that's enough. My friend, your woman has already gone feral. I was a fifth grade soccer coach once, do not ask. It was a bad time of my life. I know. And you're right, it's not even a real goddamn sport. No one ever got that brain damage, but I did my best. Yes, I did. It was hard, but we made some progress. Taught those kids to be number one, what it takes to get to the top, what steroids to take. Gave them the same as I give my beef herd. Had to gamble on sports, had to snap another kid's Achilles tendon behind the referee's back so he never walks right again. Stuff winners gotta do to get the job done. How to cover up the smell of marijuana by blowing through a toilet paper roll with dry sheets stuffed inside. How to leave a woman. I taught each of those boys the facts of life and how it is never about the woman's pleasure. Never, absolutely never about that woman's pleasure. Parents won't tell you the truth, but a man with a beer in his hand will. And the fact is, you do whatever it takes to win. If that wife of yours don't want to understand, don't want to let the boy play some goddamn football, then she's got to go, Mike. Mike, are you with me? You there, son?
I'm here, Dwayne.
Hear the words that I'm saying. She's got to go, Mike.
I know, Dwayne. I'll speak to a lawyer.
Lawyer? Fancy talk. I recommend drowning, Mike. Real men don't use lawyers. Show your boy what it means to be a man. press her under the surface of the fluids. Mike, please.
Okay. Well, good show, son.
Thank you, son. Now, we call this show Beyond Insemination because it's about what men like to do besides working on the farm. It's about what we were meant to do, man against nature. I'm highly skilled at the art of noodling in a beaver dam. I do not like the animals that consider themselves engineers. I like planting and herbivores you can fatten up, give a loving name to, then callously kill and cook like a civilized man.
Fans of the role-playing game Fallout, Fallout 3, Fallout New Vegas, and the only graphic novel about the Fallout universe, that's Fallout, the Descendants of Vaults 42, 43, and 55, available on Amazon.com, OutskirtsPress.com, Barnes & Nobles, and Goodreads.com, and you can download it to your mobile phone. As a fan, I wrote this book for fans who are pretty much tired of waiting for Fallout 4. So many other games have come and gone. But, you know, I salute the mod builders and the people who play Fallout and Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas on their PCs, and they keep the game fresh. For me, this is one of the best role-playing games that have been ever produced. The moral implications of how you go about living your life are very important in Fallout 3. And Fallout 3 differs from Fallout New Vegas. If you've been following my blog and the games that I posted, you can see the big difference has to be New Vegas is the sun, the sky. Well, in Fallout 3, it's a little bit more dreary. But that adds to the story. Fallout 3 is a better story. Now, when it comes to good story, the only graphic novel about the Fallout universe is Fallout, the Descendants of Vaults 42, 43, and 55. We have new wastelands to explore, some of the same enemies, predators, different enemies, and definitely different heroes. In the Fallout universe that I've created as a fan for fans, it's beautiful, and you need to check it out today.
Now on all you gappers, and you finger snappers, and toe tappers, and you love lappers, I want y'all to say this with me.
All right, I think that's what I need to be.
still on the ball. Oh,
Why are HMOs making record profits while our economy is in recession? And why are the people paying more for healthcare than any other country?
What do you want us to do? Go out of business? Listen, it's easy. Invest. Then when our share prices go up because of the, listen to this bit, responsible way, yes, responsible way we have run our business, including sensible maintaining of lots of friends on Capitol Hill, you'll see the upside. And you want to complain because we're doing so well? What's your problem? You're still alive to moan and groan about how horrible our healthcare is.
Exactly. Pharmaceutical company profits aren't the problem. They're the solution. We need that money to fly doctors to golf retreats in the Caribbean.
Oh, man.
We are literally saving communities out there. In the old days, it was all about fishing and smoking pot, but now it's all about golf courses and other cultural things like that. All because of the money that has moved into healthcare. Do you know how much a lab monkey costs? And you end up stoning them to the tits on exciting new breakthroughs in medical science so much that they drop like flies left and right from the sheer joy. Progress ain't cheap, and you worry about costs?
Luis's cure erectile dysfunction? I use them all the time.
Okay, another good point by Mr. Mason, but let's get to our next topic. Should we go natural in our healthcare?
Definitely. And we're happy to cover everything as long as you reach your $10,000 deductible. Isn't that great? We cover all the expenses after you've spent $10,000. We are saving you money.
Sorry.
I guess your pills ain't working, lady. Well, you know, let me tell you, the fact is, and it's a fact, drugs are killing us, man.
You people are heading towards the dark ages. Up until the 1950s, this country was sick, diseased with worry. We helped usher in change with drugs perfect for an America coping with anxiety due to the civil rights movement. You guys want to take us back to home medicine? Please, you will kill people with your nonsense. The fact is, the only thing that makes people better is drugs. Not hokum pokum, not shitting in a bag and sleeping with my dad. Narcotics are what matters. Drugs, they work. Trust me, I've been on them for years.
What works?
Drugs are hokum pokum. That's hokum pokum. I'm telling you the truth.
No one knows what officially is hokum pokum, and that's a fact. What works is a fully integrated spreadsheet pyramid with diagnostics at the center and patient recovery being at the top, which it always is with us here at Copay Insurance.
What matters is holistics and getting well from psilocybin colonics.
Does he have like a translator or something? Because I understand every fifth word he's saying.
He's talking about holistics.
Oh. Holistics, man! Drilling holes! It's an ancient form of medicine. If you had a headache, people run over to you and start drilling a hole in your head. If you had a heartburn, they drill a hole in your heart. If you practice witchcraft, they drown you or burn you just to check. It worked for centuries.
He's talking more to himself.
Rabbit talk about, oh, I want to make this much this year off a person who can't breathe right. Oh, I want to make that much off this doctor who is ignoring the world.
Okay, thank you, mate.
Playing golf.
You are giving me a headache.
Good. I can cure that. Come here.
What are you doing, Mr. Mason?
Come here. I'm getting...
No,
this won't hurt a bit. My dad showed me. Come here.
Okay, come on, Mr. Mason.
No, the drill bit's clean,
damn it. Let's put down the drill. Let's think about Reiki or something.
What the hell are you talking about?
Please stop.
Oh, you calm the fuck down or the pitch bitch gets it.
Please.
That's enough, Mr. Mason.
I'm a good person.
You ain't no good person. You ain't even a person, man.
I've got some free samples.
Yeah, that's all you are, is a vending machine of samples.
Just don't trepanate me, please. I'll pay you.
Man, you think I want your goddamn blood money? I'm gonna free mankind of drugs that cost money.
No.
Or that you can't grow or find on shit.
No!
Okay.
No,
okay,
listen
now,
to what
now
I'm
calm
saying.
Down.
It's
I think
you.
We've had enough.
It's you're the insurance guy. One of you gets drilled, I ain't taking no for an answer.
Please leave me out of this. She's the one with the headache. I respect alternative therapies. They give false hope.
Are you kidding? I'm gonna drill the smugness right out of your third eye.
Impossible.
Drill him. He's let kids die. He refused a little girl a liver transplant.
Nonsense.
All right, you're the one.
She was too risky to save. Nonsense. She was too risky to save. Risky for third quarter
too
earnings.
Too risky to save.
Drill her. She kept AIDS drugs out of the hands of poor people so that her CEO could buy a plane.
No, that's a lie. It was a boat, not a plane.
It's planes, boats, corporations, neckties. Dark smoke comes floating out of your skull, and the demons that have been controlling your life comes out of your skull. You think I'm messing around?
I know you're not messing around. I tell you what, Mr. Mason, just drill them both, please. But just hurry up, because that's about all the time we have for folks this week on the pacemaker.
No joke.
No,
no,
that's enough.
Fast-paced modern life, sometimes you just have to live 24/7. All action, non-stop, on the go, with Latin passion. Mas Fuego. Get the fire. Mas Fuego is an entirely new concept in beverage technology. It's a drink that is full of caffeine that keeps you awake and makes you anxious.
Oh, it makes my boyfriend crazy. He's like a Latin bull, even though he's a Chinese. Tears me to pieces.
Now, that's some Latin passion. Mas Fuego. Synthesized Latin testosterone energy drink. Live life to the limit.
I want to salute the mod builders, the PC players who keep the Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas experience fresh, because we have no idea there's going to be a Fallout 4. Let's be frank. Bethesda is making so much money on their other games. They don't seem to want to commit to anything to a new Fallout franchise. And if they are, there's no reason not to tell your fan base. Your fan base has been waiting for a new Fallout games, you know, for the last, 7 years? So a lot of things have changed. There are a lot of things that I would love to see if there was a Fallout 4, if there is going to be a Fallout 4. Because all I can do as a fan, create my own universe where I took the same Predators, came up with different heroes and different villains in different vaults. Fallout, the Descendants of Vaults 42, 43, and 55 is the only graphic novel about the Fallout experience. It can be the next Fallout 4, but it's only due to the fans. And as a fan, I wrote the book for fans. You can find Fallout, the Descendants of Vaults 42, 43, and 55 available on Amazon.com, Barnes & Nobles, OutskirtsPress.com as a download directly to your mobile. It's the only new wasteland out there, fans. I wrote it for you. Enjoy.
Back to beavers. I once stuck my arm in a dam, and four or five of them, an entire family, in fact, of beavers, bit into my arm. Got every last one of them on the grill that night and a couple of new hats. For the record, I also do not like fire ants, as it is unreasonable to have a social structure of a bunch of neutered men acting as slaves for a woman. Outside of a modern city, of course, where it appears to be mandatory. They call them places offices. I will not sit in a cubicle like a veal calf while a woman shouts at me about making personal calls until I die. Caller, you're on the show. To whom am I speaking?
Hey there, Dwayne. The name's Charlie. Hope all's going well with your divorce.
No, amigo. It is, in fact, crappy as crappy could be. As I said, avoid lawyers at all costs. Now continue.
Well, yeah, my best friend died in a combine accident, and he left me a few head of cattle, but I ain't no farmer, so question is, how do I know if a female cow is in heat? They don't talk or nothing, they just move.
Oh, Charlie, that's simple. You have come to the right place, as I am an expert on estrus. What you gotta do is look for behavioral signs such as incessant mooing, but most of all, she will exhibit more vigorous interaction with other females, putting her chin on the rump of another cow and...
Oh yeah? Yeah, keep going. Tell me about that dirty heifer.
God damn it. You are sitting there with a hot laptop on your sweaty thighs doing an image search for heifers, aren't you? Jesus. I'm tired of you sickos calling up and ruining my otherwise flawless broadcasting flow. This is a civilized show for civilized people, discussing a variety of topics relating and beyond insemination. Why, oh, why does this subject matter attract such a variety of perverts, creeps, and weirdos? It is quite beyond me. Now, don't get me wrong, I mean, I like a good time. I've been known to participate in a pheromone party where you do not shave or bathe for 1 week and then partake in moonshine and speed with a group of other like-minded individuals in a hot tub. It is hell on the other side of that party, but it is worth the ride. But that does not mean I find calling up a radio program about rural affairs and pleasuring myself while perusing the heifer section of the information superhighway an acceptable form of behavior. Is that clear? Charlie, you pervert, is that clear?
Yes.
Are we straight, son?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now you take care, you hear?
Thank you, sir.
I am lost for words. Next caller.
Hi there, Dwayne. My name is Susan. I
really like what you said about how animals have babies and then they abandon them and then they go find another mate. Oh, that just touched me. That made me cry. It reminded me when I left little Mary Sue outside the Up and Adam restaurant. I was tired of all her crying and carrying on anyway. Cause I just hooked up with a guy I just met named Francis.
Oh, well, good on you, Susan. Though I am not a fan of names that can apply to a man or a woman, unisexuality has neutered our society. No man should be named Francis or Alex or Jamie or, God forbid, Casey. But anyway, I'm so glad we inspired you. That's evolved thinking right there. See, we do believe in evolution in the right situation. For the record, not me, nor no one in my family was ever no monkey. Nor have they been with a monkey, not ever, not even at the zoo. Nor pretty much any animal, aside from usual ones we all practice on. There, that's cleared up. Science and truth can exist together, you see. We can learn a lot from nature. You know how a mama puppy cleans up after a litter by eating their waste? My mom ate all her boys poop till we were five. It was unconventional, but it sure made us the people we are today. Social services said this had something to do with the lab her and my daddy had cooking up toilet cleaner, but I would disagree ferociously. I would even go as far as to challenge you to a knife fight. You want to come and talk some shit like that? We will tie our wrists together and solve this in a time-honored way. That's my mama you're speaking about. You take that back, you hear me? That's my mama. Get off my phone and get off my show. Disrespecting a man's mama like that. Now then, changing tack for one special moment. Well, we all know that part of being a man is heeding the call of nature to kill it and serve it grilled to members of your family and or tribe. I have been hunting since I was a small boy, and I can, in fact, track more than 16 different species of ruminant animal. While our olfactory senses have been dulled as hell by so-called civilization, in nature, all they got is smell. I know how to assimilate the odor of any species. I rub the pheromones all over my member. Trust me, when you have a young fawn experiencing his first adolescent flush, a sexual awakening, run out of the woods filled with a yearning it scarcely understands, well, it really is something special when you grab it by the neck and strangle the life out of it. As his terrified eyes look up at you, it suddenly realizes, hey, you ain't my mom, and you sure as shit ain't some young stag gonna gently educate in the ways of the birds and the bees. And in this way, you two really share a special moment. His terror takes hold of its central nervous system, and you put the creature out of its misery. You ever have deer sushi? A little rice and wasabi and some fine loin meat? I'll serve it up on my stepdaughter just like they do in Asia. I am particularly interested in visiting Asia. I've always been kind to the Asiatic cultures. I've always enjoyed them, from kung fu to martial arts and fucking throwing stars. I'd really love to see Thailand, though. Somebody say ping pong? Just saying, not judging. Hey, my way, Johnny, you are on the show.
It's right here, my bad, I'm sorry. So I want to help you ladies with questions you have, anything you might have, some about a man that throws you off, some about your man that drives you crazy. I'll fix it in 13 seconds. You don't need no long counselings. Any woman, somebody man make you mad, anything, something, shout it out, shout it. Be romantic. What does that mean? You got to be specific with a man. I don't know what you're talking about. Be romantic. What? Fix the screen door? What? What do you want me to do? I want romance. I want romance. What? Hold your hand? What? Then say it. Look at your man. Hold my hand. Ah, I got it. Now you finally got what you're looking for. I want romance. Can you read those books? How to make love last forever. How to have romance forever. Too much work. Just say what you want. You got a man always forget your birthday? Forget that. Buy yourself a car. Look what you got me. He'll remember next year. I'll never forget your birthday again. That one cost me a lot of money. Okay, I'm gonna help. What confuses you most about women? I'll fix it. What confuses you most about women? I'm gonna fix it for you. I'm gonna help you understand it. That they act like nothing. You're not married, are you? Because you're talking. She ain't here, is she? Why are you talking? You ain't learned nothing. You haven't learned nothing in your life. That's why you stay in trouble. You gotta live in you. You know what she did? She did this. So you don't know what that means. You're a single man. That means this man's in trouble. He don't even understand. She did that. They gonna be in the car.
What?
Why you always gotta say something?
He asked me something.
That's a man that's sleeping downstairs tonight. Look at all these men. Look at these married men sitting. They're trying to assume the position of getting in no trouble. That's your job as a man, to get in trouble. That's your job. Your problem is you trying not to be in trouble. Accept the trouble and be sarcastic with it. Piss them off. That's half the fun of being married. You did that on purpose. Oh, yes, I did. That's foreplay. They need to have training for husbands, men training for husbands. How to be a husband, how to talk, how to survive a day. You gotta practice, you gotta look in the mirror. What? Oh no, you gotta learn to make those faces. Act like you're trying to speak, but don't let nothing come out. Don't say nothing, but act like you're trying to be involved.
In Fallout, the descendants of Vaults 42, 43, and 55, music and stand-up comedy didn't just die during the Great War. There's too many scavengers out there scavenging, and they were bound to find more music. The problem was that the developers didn't think about licensing music as the way Grand Theft Auto and Saints Row did. I don't know if there's ever going to be a Fallout 4. I'm tired of the rumor mill. As a fan, I came up with a graphic novel for other fans like me who consistently play Fallout 3, who consistently play Fallout 4. It's us, we the fans, who have kept the game fresh by developing new mods, developing new wastelands, developing new takes on a role-playing game that, for some of us, this happens to be one of the most better or best games of its generation. So if you're looking for a new wasteland, and you know, we all started off reading. If you don't like reading, then understand reading is for lovers. And if you don't like reading, you probably don't like love either. But if you are into reading, and you are into happiness, and you are into experiencing wasteland tales that have the same enemies, the same mutated creatures, but different heroes in a different wasteland, stories crafted for you, then go to Amazon.com or OutskirtsPress.com. and type in Fallout, the Descendants of Vaults 42, 43, and 55. It's available on paperback and download to your mobile.